MHP has passed the halfway point in construction of a new addition. Work on the project has been going on for a little more than a year now. CRI's Aaron Riggs gives us a look inside as some of the rooms start to take shape.
Project's going well.
Progress is being made with less than a year remaining in the construction of the new patient care wing at Mahaska Health Partnership. Progress that's creating some excitement.
It's just an exciting time for us to be in a facility where we're able to provide the quality of facility that matches the quality of staff that we have providing such outstanding service, and we're excited to be able to provide it.
Once completed, the patient care wing will be the new home for the surgical, birthing, and inpatient services, and will boast several improvements over the more than 45-year-old space the services currently call home. Among the list of updates and improvements, 3 surgery rooms, 2 endoscopy rooms, 5 intensive care units, 5 birthing rooms with 2 more available for overflow, as well as 25 traditional inpatient hospital rooms. Improvements in the surgical rooms include high ceilings and steel supports that hold booms for modern surgical equipment.
Okay. These are the new booms that we're installing. On these will be mounted surgical lights and the medical gas connections.
Elevators in the surgical area allow patient privacy before and after surgical procedures.
This is a new elevator that's going in, so we can transport patients from surgery back up to inpatient.
Upstairs are the birthing and inpatient rooms. The 5 dedicated birthing rooms are larger than the current ones, each with a bathroom and a whirlpool tub.
This is the bathroom, and in here will be a toilet, a whirlpool tub, and a shower and a sink. And it's all designed to be wheelchair accessible.
And when the babies are born, parents will get to show off their newborns in the nursery.
You can see that there's a window over here on this side so that visitors walking down the hall can look at the babies.
The new inpatient rooms also have improvements.
These are all private rooms, and they have their own restroom. They're a lot larger than the current rooms that we have.
And in the hallway outside the hospital rooms,
there's a nook for each one of the patient rooms
for nurses to do charting or gather supplies.
Hey, how's it going?
Down the hall from the inpatient rooms are the intensive care units.
It's for critical patients.
One of which is called an anti-room, which means air only flows into the room and then out through special air vents.
So if we get a patient with like tuberculosis, we put them in this room.
Christensen expects the staff to be able to move into the new wing this September and to begin operating shortly after.
We want to make sure we allow time so that we open and everything's in place and running smooth first.
As for the old building, Christensen expects to give that space a new purpose.
We will have a lot of available space in the existing facility, that some of which will be directed towards new services that we're going to be determining over probably the next 12 months.
Making healthcare in Mahaska County, like in the country generally, an ever-evolving industry. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Aaron Riggs.
The intensive care anti-room will be the first of its kind at MHP.